The student of the Greek mysteries, who was hoping that sometime he might become an initiate, passed through certain trials, tests, examinations, and preparations, which would not apparently be essentially associated with any form of ceremonialism. For example, a promising young man who hoped to become accepted into the mysteries was first of all examined by his tutor or by whoever was his ordinary and common instructor. That is, the equivalent of the modern schoolmaster in the community where he dwelt. He was tested in all the common forms of knowledge. The test seemed to suggest an entry examination into a scholastic institution. After he had been carefully examined in mathematics, astronomy, music, poetry, art, literature, and drama, and whatever other arts or sciences were regarded as necessary, he was then turned over to the chief magistrate of the city or town, where a thorough investigation of his background, his family, and everything relating to his character was undertaken. If there was any blemish or doubt concerning his moral or his ethical standard of life, he would be immediately rejected. So having been examined in all arts and sciences and endorsed as to character in all regards, he was then submitted to the priestly members of the priestly college, these being the essential guardians of the ritual. Here, certain further instruction and interrogation took place. He was given various problems to solve involving various degrees of thoughtfulness. His physical health and stamina were tested. He was forced to compete in physical games or athletics to indicate fitness of body. He was subjected to many trials of the flesh, of fasting, of extreme hardship, of the inclemency of weather. He was given every kind of an examination that might suggest ways of probing into the self-mastery which he possessed in the various ordinary affairs of life. Only after he had been tested in all these matters was he then further instructed and prepared for the actual initiatory rites. There is no indication in the Greek rites that the candidates actually participated in the ceremony. In the Lycinia, for example, at the bestowing of the lesser ritual, perhaps 25,000 persons were initiated at one time. Now, in this case, the initiation ritual, which was called the Lesser Rite, probably derived from the old idea of the bestowal of citizenship. This is interesting, however, because in the lesser rituals of the Lycinia, small children were initiated. And there are records of children being initiated as early as their second and third years. Thus, we must wonder a little as to what the esoteric content of such a ritual might imply. In this ritual also, there was no distinction between men and women. Persons of both sexes were equally initiated, and initiation consisted apparently of beholding the spectacle, or in some way being present when a great drama was bestowed. Obviously, however, this dramatic part, especially in relation to the lesser mystery, was really only a fulfillment of the previous requirements, namely that the individual was present and permitted to partake of this ritual only because he had already been established on the level of his education and the level of his character by the proper endorsing officers. Thus, this was simply a symbol of his right to be there. How and why small children attained this right is still one of the unsolved problems of the Eleusinian ritual. We know, for instance, that among the Greeks came into existence most of the arts and sciences of Western culture. We know that the Greeks were master mathematicians. We know that they established the foundations of music and astronomy. We know that they were leaders of the world in rhetoric, in logic, and in many other branches of learning. These forms of learning all apparently originated in the temple. All of the greater initiates were men of unusual scholarship, and nearly all of the great scholars of the Greeks were initiates. This seems to suggest that in some way the arts and sciences of the Greeks must have arisen from certain speculations held within the temple, or practiced or revealed through the temple ceremony. And there is also much to suggest that in these ceremonies, anything that was known in arts and sciences would have been used as adroitly and skillfully as possible to advance the general purpose of initiation.
But in the reappearance of the Christ and the Masters of Wisdom, Krim reveals that Freemasonry will play an important part in the return of, quote, the Christ, end quote, whom Christians would call the Antichrist, especially in the initiation ritual for the New Age religion. He says, and this is Benjamin Krim, quote, through the Masonic tradition and certain esoteric groups, remember I told you it's all of the secret societies and fraternal brotherhoods, that's what he means by esoteric groups, will come the process of initiation. And you can interpret that as the brainwashing that you get through the material put out by Walt Disney Corporation, through a visit to the Luxor Hotel and the MGM Grand in Las Vegas, and many other things where you go in and while you're staying there, actually receive the 3 degrees of initiation of the Blue Lodge, and leave, when you do leave, as a Freemason without portfolio, and all of this happens without you even knowing that anything transpired. Same with your children when they watch Walt Disney movies and listen to the songs. They're being inculcated into the beliefs, the dogma of the New Age, of the New World Order, and they are being propagandized into accepting it.
Thus, he tells us in this opera that the mysteries as we knew them are gone, but that society itself is now the place of initiation, that in the conspiracies of states and nations, in the tyranny of despots, and in the constant struggle for human life, man is passing through the subterranean passages of an initiation rite. And he now has a very wonderful and all-sufficient guide and leader in the form of Sarastro. Increasing knowledge, universal education, the public school system, and all these things. Imperfect, certainly, but imperfect only because man is willing to permit them to be that way. Because Sarastro can be merely a demagogue, as he represents education.
Me and my arrow. I don't know. hiccup, just a breakup, I'll carry on. Oh yes, I will. Me and my arrow, do 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 do, straight up the narrow. Wherever we go, everyone knows it's me and my arrow. Me and my arrow.